so, so much for coming. I've been wanting to do this for literally forever. I've been taking piano since I was 7 years old, and I've been taking piano from Kathleen Baker since I was 10, and she's been absolutely fabulous, so a huge thank you to her. She's kept me organized, because you know me, I'm just like, we'll see what happens, and she's like, okay, let's organize this, what song comes first, let's time it. So she's been really, really wonderful. So a huge thank you to you. I'm just going to do all my thank yous now. To my parents, they've been really, really supportive of me throughout the years and so helpful. And my sisters have come to like all my shows and sat through them all, which they're really long sometimes, so a big thank you to them as well. So today, kind of what I'm going to do is do a whole bunch of different random things. Some jazz, some musical theater, some opera. I love singing songwriting, so I'm going to play some of the songs that I've written, because that's what I'm going to be doing in the future, like in college and stuff. I've been playing a few classical piano pieces for you. So what I'm going to start with is a jazz song. I've loved jazz since like 7th grade. In 7th grade, I started playing piano for the homeschool little jazz band and fell in love. And they are just my band fam, and I love them all so, so much. But like 3-ish years ago, we sang a song called Summertime. Many of you might know it. And kind of one of my rules when I do songs that aren't mine is I listen to it like once or twice, and then I just do my own little thing because I don't want to sound like someone else. I want to sound like Hilty. So Kathleen and I, we kind of rewrote this song a little bit and changed it. So I hope you enjoy Summertime. Chopin, and I kid you not, I used to think it was Chopin, like till very recently. And so we were working she's like, it's Chopin. So Frederick Chopin's Waltz.
Next piece
is one that's really, really close to my heart. I wrote it a couple years ago for a competition I was in. And I wrote around how I was feeling at the time, because you know, a lot of people look like they have it together. And so people would come up to me and say, oh, it looks like you're doing great, you have your life together. Or, you know, I'd look at everyone and be like, oh, wow, all these people are so perfect. And lately God has kind of been giving me this image of we're all like living life on a stage, and we all have center stage where the lights are on and we're looking good, but then there's a backstage too. And this is kind of a song that's saying it's okay to show the backstage. No one wants our audience to see what's back there, but it's really, really good and it's healthy and that's real. And so this song is written about not comparing what we know our insides to be to what we see as other people's outsides.
Of their insides are nowhere to be seen. All this seems to do is break her self-esteem. When she looks at others and sees this fake display, the way she knows her insides just make her feel disgraced. Don't compare your insides to everyone's outsides. Don't compare.
University in Nashville, Tennessee to study commercial music. I am so excited. excited. We're gonna do like some songwriting stuff and some probably recording stuff and just learning how to market. So I'm really excited for that. But here it is, Il Mio Bel Fuoco.
Thank you.
I'm going to do is one that's my most recent song that I've written. I wrote it for my graduating class. I actually auditioned a couple weeks ago to sing it for graduation. I don't know if they'll have a spot for it or not. But either way, I have a new song. But it's called Blessing, and it's really written around just like I thought at our first graduation meeting about 9 months ago. I was like, wow, like I love all these people so much. And then in 9 months, like when we're on that graduation stage, it's probably the last time I'm gonna see some of them till heaven, hopefully, and just like sending them off with a prayer and talking about how the world is hard and there are trials in the world, and you know, we're gonna walk into that, but God is victorious through that, and we need to focus on His promises. So this is a song about that. New paths, new trails, new hikes. Nothing can keep us from the skies. And we must fix our there will be ups and downs. Some days we will feel bound up. So I pray. This is my blessing over you, that you'll hold fast in all you do. Every trial you walk through, you'll have strength to speak the truth. You'll keep running in this race, holding strong to love and faith. Your eyes fixed on Jesus' face. He's the author, He's the way. And in the end, if nothing else is said, this will hold true. He will always love you. I love musical theater. I've taken voice lessons for 4 years, from 10th grade, 7th grade to 10th grade, and musical theater was pretty much the only thing I did, and I fell in love with it. So this piece is from Thoroughly Modern Millie, called Gimme Gimme, and it's the story, I'll be honest, I actually just looked it up backstage because I was like, I don't know the story behind the song, and I need to tell them what it is. So the story that I just learned is that this girl, she's like moving from a small town, and she's going to the big city, I think New York, and she wants to find a secretary job for a really rich businessman, and then like get him to fall in love with her. And then she falls in love with this like bum on the streets, and he ends up being like the richest man in New York, so it ends up working for her favor. But yeah, this is kind of her contemplation song. I'm gonna grab a drink really quick. Okay, gimme, gimme. A simple choice, nothing more. This or that, either or. Merry world, social world, businessman, clever girl, or pin my future on a green glass bird. What kind of life am I dreaming of? I say. songs that I've done like throughout high school, but this is a totally new one. We were in Branson about a month ago and I heard it. I was like, I have to sing that song. So here's Andra Day's Rise Up.
You're broken down and tired of living life on a merry-go-round, and you can't find the fighter, but I see it in you, so we gonna walk it out and move. Mountains, we gonna walk it out and move.
Anymore. And it's just a huge part of my life. And So when I was like 10 years old, this sounds so insignificant, but my best friend moved away and it was like earth shattering for me. And like, she was the only person I was really connected to, and she was where I found my worth. And so throughout my life, struggling with where I find my worth has been really, really hard. And she was where my worth was rooted in, and she uprooted it, and she left, and she moved. And so there was about 2 years of my life where I was just really, really sad. No one like invited me over for 2 years, and I was just a mess. I was so sad. And I know this sounds sad, but it gets better, I promise. I started writing songs about the struggles that I went through. And another thing that's been really, really hard in my life, since I was like in first grade, people, I hate the word bully, but people have unkindly used their words and their actions towards me, and that's something that I've really taken to heart a lot of times, and that's been really hard and rough throughout elementary school, middle school, high school. And at that point in my life, a lot of the positive feedback that I was getting from people that were my peers, besides my parents, but like when you're 10, your parents' opinion doesn't count. And so, but they were very encouraging. But I was getting a lot of negative feedback, and the two things that shown out to me was people would say, oh, you know, I like how you dress or your hair. And so I thought, okay, outward appearance, that's really, really important. And if I can focus on that, if I can make myself look a little bit better, then people are gonna accept me and they're gonna love me. And people are always like, you know, I like when you play piano or you perform. So I thought, okay, well, if I can train, if I can be the best, and if I can let people see me perform and see me get better and better and win all the competitions, then maybe they'll love me and they'll accept me. And ultimately, that probably pushed people away because none of us are perfect and we know it. But that was really hard, and because I would never meet the standards that I set for myself, I got really, really anxious and really, really depressed, and it was super, super hard time in my life. And about 2 years ago, all the auditions that I was doing, they were failing, and I wasn't looking the way I wanted, so I started going on diets to make my skin look better. It was a really dark time for me. And I didn't want to leave my house. I didn't want to see people. And like, honestly, who's looking at me? No one. But I thought everyone was paying attention and cared, but no one really does. But through that, the only thing that kept me going was Jesus. And there were times when I didn't want to keep going anymore. And I don't know that I could say without Jesus, if I would get to be here doing this today. And so I'm really, really thankful for who he is. And ultimately, we can never rise up without Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
The wrath of God.
Jesus commands my destiny. No power of hell, no escape of man could ever rob me from his hand. Salutary calls me home.
God uses everything for our good and His glory. And throughout all those trials, I can see Him at work. And we can't always look back and say, you know, I understand why it happened, or I understand why I struggled with depression, or why I still do now. But I know that God is good and that He uses everything. And one of the things that I learned throughout all of that was that I really love ministering to girls who feel unworthy or who don't have their worth based in the right place in Jesus Christ. And so that's a huge passion of mine that I hope to use with my music in the future. As well as just, I wrote a lot of songs during that time. And sometimes in our dark times, we're able to, you know, write music that will speak to other people in their dark times. And so again, I hope to be using that in my future as well. And in the end, you know, I love singing, I love performing, I love doing all this, but that's not the reason I'm here. I'm here because Jesus gave me the breath in my lungs and the little tones or whatever they are in my vocal cords and the muscles in our fingers, and He gives us all our talents and giftings to use for Him. And I want you, if you know Jesus, to see a clearer picture of Him today. And if you don't, I want you to meet Him here today, the God who created the universe. There's no way this is by accident. There's no way you walked in this room and thought, wow, it's insane how this all appeared, and the piano was set up, and it was all tuned, and Hilsey's here, and our piano teacher's here, and we're all here, and the chairs are, there's no way. And yet, like, the human cell is so much more intricate, and yet there was a gap between us and heaven, oil and water, like sin and perfection, and we could not cross it. And God, knowing that out of His deep love for us, built a bridge, and that bridge was Jesus. And Jesus came and lived a perfect life willingly here on earth and died for our sins on a cross. And lately I've been thinking, you know, when I have guilt or something, it's really, really heavy. And then I think, wow, if I had like a whole year's worth of guilt on me at one time, that would be like insanely heavy. And then I think of, you know, my lifetime's worth of guilt on me at one time and how heavy that would be. And yet Jesus on the cross during those 3 hours of darkness, He took the guilt and the sin and the shame from Adam to Jesus, from Jesus till now, and the people will be born next day and the next day and the next day from now on. And all that guilt was on Him. And ultimately our sin did crush Him, but He was victorious and He came back to life. And I want you to know, if you're on the way home and you get in a car accident, do you know where you're gonna go? Because if you don't, I want you to meet Jesus here today. The simple act of just believing. It's not what you do. The Bible says, for by grace you have been saved through faith, not of yourselves. It is the gift of God, not of works, so that no one could boast. If we could do it, if we could earn it, then there would be no point in Jesus. We might as well nail ourselves to His cross. He already carried it. It is finished. And so I encourage you to consider your eternal destiny today. And if you don't know where you're going, talk to God. He's always there, and tell Him that you want a changed life, and He will do it.
Amen.
Amen.
So, in conclusion today is a song that's super, super close to my heart. It was written around 40 different influential women in my life. Many of them who are here, I love you all. But I wrote down their names about a couple years ago, and then wrote down attributes I really appreciated about them. And someone gave me a picture. Tommy, she's right there. She gave me a picture that said, she leaves a little sparkle wherever she goes. And so I wrote a song off that. And I wish I left sparkles wherever I go. And we all leave trails, whether we like it or not. I don't leave sparkles all everywhere I go. I wish in heaven I will, probably. Like, if you know me, sparkles are my favorite color, my favorite condiment, and like, you name it, I use glitter for it. So this is about my favorite color, sparkles, and some of my favorite people.
is manifest, hidden in her walls. Mother, sister, friends, titles untold. Her joy builds bridges to their souls. She drops a little sparkle wherever she goes. Oh, she drops a little sparkle wherever she goes. She finds the good in everyone she knows. Her smile lets kind show. She drops a little sparkle wherever she goes. She finds the good in those she knows. Loves them through the hurt they own. Sees their future, not the truth they've known. She drops a little sparkle wherever she goes. She drops a little sparkle wherever she goes. She finds the good in everyone she knows. Her smile lets kind show. She drops a little sparkle wherever she goes. She drops a little sparkle wherever she goes. She finds the good in everyone she knows. Her smile lets kind show. She drops a little sparkle wherever she goes. Drop a little sparkle wherever you go. Find the good in everyone you know. Leave a smile that kind of show. Drop a little sparkle wherever you go.
So I hope you have a wonderful afternoon, and there's so many faces that I haven't seen in like forever, so please don't leave without me getting to say hello to you. Have a wonderful evening. Thank you.